This is NPR.
You're listening to member-supported National Public Radio, KPCC FM 89.3, Pasadena, Los Angeles, Orange County, a home of classic American music. And for the next hour, we visit with guitarist Joe Pass, a brand new record on Telarc Jazz entitled My Song, a tribute to Wes Montgomery. Joe Pass with Joe Wes on KPCC.
Thank you.
classic American music on KPCC from guitarist Joe Pass, solo effort, song for Ellen, the name of that piece, and Joe Wes, a tribute to Wes Montgomery on KPCC FM 89.3, your home for classic American music. For the next half hour, we'll visit with guitarist Joe Pass, a new CD out on Telarc, and a good morning to Joe.
Good morning, Fred.
How are you?
Okay.
A new release, a reunion of old friends, this record, a recording you did back in the 60s?
Oh, yeah. This is one of two or three that I did recently, this one on Telarc, recorded with people that I recorded with in the 60s, Jim Ewart, Colin Bailey, John Pisano. We made an album called For Django, long time ago, and then we got together again 20 or 30 years later. I don't know how many years.
33, perhaps?
Wow.
Yeah, you have a love for well-crafted songs, and it is expressed in the music of Duke Ellington, Hoagy Carmichael, Fats Waller, Dave Brubeck, and others on this latest CD. You're in L.A. to perform at Vine Street Bar and Grill Thursday through Saturday nights this week.
Yeah, that's right.
And who's joining you on the gig?
Nobody.
Solo guitar?
I play solo. I play 90% of my gigs are solo.
Mm-hmm.
Some 10% are with the rhythm section. I'm playing with this rhythm section in San Francisco in January and in Seattle and maybe in Japan in the fall, but with Jim and John and Colin. But I don't play too much with the rhythm section. Once in a while I play with Niels Pedersen, the bass player.
Mm-hmm. Vine Street Bar and Grill is located at 1610 North Vine Street in Hollywood. For ticket information, you can call area code 213-463-4375 to see Joe Pass in performance, solo guitar, at Vine Street. Classic American music on KPCC. We've been listening to the new album. Let's talk about Tom Rainier.
Yeah, I was going to just say Tom is on this album, and Tom is a wonderful musician. I had heard of him and heard him play some years back. And he's very, very busy in studios. He does everything, movies and TV and recording. And it was suggested that I add a piano, you know, or a keyboard. And we're talking, and I said, Tom Rainier, Bob Enevoldsen, Bob Edmondson, rather, who produced this album for me, is a friend of mine, suggested Tom, and I'd heard Tom play, but I didn't know he played saxophone and clarinet and bass and drums and congas and I don't know what. He plays everything and good. So I called Tom and he was able to do the album and I had him play clarinet on some tracks.
Soprano?
A soprano and tenor besides piano.
Mm-hmm.
And he's an excellent, excellent musician.
When we get back to the music, we'll hear Tom on soprano doing Hoagy Carmichael's Rockin' Chair.
Yeah, that's a favorite tune of mine, old Rockin' Chair about me.
Yeah. You got any favorite composers besides Hoagy?
Well, I like, Harold Arlen. I like most of the contemporary American composers. A lot of them, I don't know who they are, but I know their songs.
Mm-hmm. Tin Pan Alley writers versus today's songwriters. There's a big difference.
Well, there aren't any songwriters today. And some music, or maybe they don't call it music, but today I find that there's no melody and no harmony, just a rhythm and words. I mean, and you can't today, with the exception of a few writers, Stevie Wonder, Billy Joel, maybe a few others, you can't hum a melody. I mean, there isn't any melody that I can remember. Maybe I don't know what I'm talking about. Because I don't listen that close to music or radio.
Uh-huh. We're joined by Joe Pass this morning on KPCC, who will be at Vine Street Bar and Grill in solo performance Thursday through Saturday nights. And he's got a new album out on Telarc. It's called My Lady. And let's talk about Django Reinhardt for a moment here.
Yeah, what about him?
Cat could play, huh?
He was a great, great guitar player. I mean, unique in that he was an innovator. And you know, the history of jazz guitar, you have Charlie Christian, you have guitarists before that, Eddie Lang and all that, but then actually Charlie Christian introduced the solo guitar playing like a horn, and at the same time, Django was on the scene even before Charlie Christian and quite popular in Europe, I mean very popular, with the Hot Club of France and Stefan Grappelli. But if you trace the jazz guitar playing, you'll see many, many guitarists follow Charlie Christian's style. I'm in that line or lineage, and many, all the guitar players, very few, if any, have taken up Django's way of playing approach, you know. Very few. A couple of guys in France that are gypsies or claim to be cousins or relatives. I'm always meeting relatives of Django. They're all guitar players. But very few have followed that line. So it's funny because he was, I think, just a unique player. There's none that played like him. There's copies. But Christian set the precedent for all players. So,
and the fact that Django went through such adversity with the injury to his hand.
Yeah, that's true, yeah. I mean,
he had to work twice as hard.
Yeah, but he was gifted, you know. I mean, he's gifted. I don't think he even thought about his hand. I don't know. I don't know nothing about Django. All I know is that nobody could play like Django Reinhardt.
Joe Pass joins us. We're going to turn back to the record now, Joe. This is Rockin' Chair, which you said is one of your favorites.
One of the tunes I like, yeah.
And it features the remarkable Tom Raniere on soprano sax.
Yeah.
Joe Pass on KPCC. Thank you. Joe Pass on FM 89.3 KPCC, Old Rockin' Chair. A beautiful melody, as you say.
Yeah, I like the melody.
You talk about the relationship between melody and chord, and it's all
harmony,
intertwined harmony. Yeah.
Yeah.
How does that relate to the guitar? I mean, I've had the chance to see you play, and it's just remarkable where you're.
Well, the guitar is a chordal instrument. I mean, you know, it's like a piano.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's unlimited in what kind of harmonies you can find on the instrument. I mean, there's no end to it. You know. But how does it relate? I don't know. It has six strings, and you use them all, and it makes harmony. And if you have a good, strong melody and choice of usually if you have a good melody, you have a good harmonic pad for it, you know. It just usually goes. And I think that if, I don't know, this is like off on a tangent, but if you can't hum a melody in your mind or your head or whistle it or something, you can't play it, no matter how much you learn or how you memorize the harmony or memorize where it is on the instrument, any instrument. If you don't have the melody in your head, that's the first thing you have to have. Then you can play it. So a lot of players have the idea that if they see something on a piece of paper and memorize it, that's all they have to do. I don't know. My point is that you have to have a feeling for the melody without your instrument before you can really make something out of it.
Where are you from? Where were you born, Joe?
I was born in New Jersey,
mm-hmm.
New Brunswick, but I moved to Johnstown, Pennsylvania when I was about 2 years old, and lived there until I was about 15 years old, and then went out on the road, and I've been on the road ever since, and I ended up in California, go west, and I came west, and that's as far west as I could get.
Never worked Hawaii, I guess, or yeah.
Oh, yeah, well, yeah, but I mean
I'm joking.
You're joking.
No, I'm not. Not with you.
I played in Hawaii and closed the club.
Don Ho, look out.
Yeah.
When did you first pick up the guitar?
I was nine years old, and I have no idea how I started. I mean, I make up stories, and the Gene Autry I saw in the movies, and he had a guitar and a horse, and I wanted the horse, but I got the guitar. But I don't know how I started. There's no one plays anything in my family. We're not musicians, and my father didn't play, my uncle, nobody. I just started playing. I don't know. There was an old guitar around that guys came over to my father's house to drink wine and play cards, and they used to play guitar and sing after they got inebriated, you know. And then somehow I was playing chords with them, and that's how I started.
Did you ever do any formal studying with a tie-collared music teacher?
I studied with a friend of the family's who was a musician. He played all the reed instruments and a piano, and he was a little bit of a guitar player. And he traveled on the road with bands like Shep Fields and things like that.
His Rippling Rhythm.
Yeah, and he didn't like the road, and he was married, so he came back, and he's an Italian guy, Nick Gimas. And he didn't want to teach anybody. He was like a grouch. He had an ulcer. But I went up there every Sunday instead of going to Mass. My brothers went to Mass, and I had to go up to the hill where he lived and take a lesson. I took about 8 or 9 months lessons, primarily beginning stuff. You know?
Mm-hmm.
So I just think that just recently I've been thinking a lot, and I've been just thinking that I guess music is a gift. I know it is from God to
mm-hmm.
me. I mean, because I don't practice and I didn't really study, and yet I know a lot of songs.
Right.
I mean, that's a joke, but anyway. So I'm thankful.
Yeah. Joe Pass joins us here on KPCC. Now, we, before we get back to the music, we want to mention the fact again that you are performing Thursday through Saturday nights at Vine Street Bar and Grill in Hollywood on solo guitar, 1610 North Vine Street, area code 213 is the number to call for ticket and reservation information, 463-4375 for Joe Pass's show coming out. And I bet you it's probably going to be sold out, so I would imagine get real busy and get to the phone and make those reservations.
Well, I hope it's sold out. You know, I play there once a year or sometimes twice.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of a place where they have good pasta and Antonio's a friend of mine, and I kind of enjoy playing there.
Intimate setting.
Yeah.
Sure, yeah. We've got a special offer for our members only now. Courtesy of Telarc and Vicky Rickman, who, Joe, is working your record like crazy nationally on radio as well as retail, has given us 5 copies of the album to give to our members. So if you are listening right now and are a member to National Public Radio on KPCC FM 89.3, call 818-585-7000, and we will give you a CD from Joe Pass on Telarc, and maybe we can convince Joe to autograph him, too. And he's not
yeah,
a
okay,
guest.
Yeah, okay.
818-585-7000 is the number to call, and we'll be glad to give you a CD.
Albums make great Christmas presents, especially CDs. They're not hard to wrap. They're easy to carry, and you can send them easily.
Low postage rate on that.
Yeah, right.
Now, again, a funny question. You had a broken leg during this recording?
Well, I had broken, shattered bones in my ankle. I fell on my on the curb in front of my apartment in January. I recorded the album in January, and it was a little tense time for me because we were recording at 11 o'clock in the morning, somewhere an hour and a half away from where we were staying, and we were playing at night in a jazz club called Yoshi's. So it was a full day. I mean, you know, going out and playing, coming back at 5 and playing at 8. And,
you're supposed to stay off your feet.
Well, yeah, I was taking some medication, you know, and that didn't really help me. It was a Vicodin or something.
Oh, my goodness.
I don't know. But, anyway, it was a really busy, busy time, more than usual. And I had this cast on my leg and a cane. Or no, a crutch. It's a crutch. Anyway, it's done and,
Well, we'll make sure we give you a copy of this, because as Joe was listening, he said, "Hey, I've never got to hear this. I haven't heard this one before."
No, I have some copies.
Or you're pulling my leg, so to speak. Sorry.
Yeah.
Joe Pass joins us on KPCC. We wish you all the best, Joe. What's in the store for the future for you?
Well, let me see. Well, in January, I'm playing in San Francisco and Seattle with this quartet. Minus Tom Rainier, and in February I'm doing a tour of Italy with a classical guitarist named Elliot Fisk.
Wow.
We split the bill, and we play a little bit together. In March I'm touring the West Coast with 4 guitarists, Pepe Romero, the great classical player, wonderful guy, Leo Kottke, unique player.
12-string player.
Yeah, great, and Paco Pina, flamenco player from Spain, and we just did a tour in the East, and it was very well received. And we're going to do the same tour in the West. We'll be at Pasadena, Ambassador, right here.
Oh yeah, exactly, here. Sure.
And Royce Hall.
Is there a name for that act?
It's called the Guitar Summit.
Oh, okay.
And each of us play our own way, and then we play together one tune at the end.
I bet you it's a finale, yeah.
But that's not the point. Is that every guitar player is totally different. And if you come to hear one type of playing, you'll be surprised by another type.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, I enjoyed the tour we did.
Are you working with any singers lately? I've not, you know, earlier we played an Ella Fitzgerald record that you worked with.
No, I don't, no, I'm not working with any singers. Am I working with any singers? No.
Is it fun to do that?
Well, it was fun to do with Ella. And it was fun to do with, some of the vocalists that I worked with. I played with Sarah Vaughan and Carmen McRae, but Ella, I did most of my playing, and that was always fun because it was always spontaneous. We never rehearsed or planned, and if you listen close to the albums I made with her, you could hear on the endings where we were going, which was nowhere. Which was like, how do we get out of this? But some things came out really good.
You know, Ella, she sings like an instrument. I mean, she scats, and with you backing her up playing chords, it's like a trumpet almost singing, or a saxophone.
Yeah, like a horn player. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. But she has a phenomenal ear. I mean, I could change keys on her and everything, which I did, because I was told not to get into a rut, you know, where we always did the same pieces all the time, which is an easy thing to do when you're touring around. Right. Is to be safe and play the same things. But we never did. We always did We would go before each concert and sit in the dressing room and say, how about Lady is a Tramp? Okay, what key? F. Okay, boom.
Okay.
And then we'd play. So it was always like a jam session.
Well, that's the key to music, I think, to keep it alive, create emotion.
Yeah, keep it
scary.
Yeah, keep it from becoming routine and stale, you know.
Don't let the groove become a rut, as my bass player used to tell me that.
Right. Yeah, right.
My bass teacher used to say, Freddie, don't let that groove become a rut now.
Yeah, right. Don't play, you know, there are no wrong notes. They're just in the wrong places.
Hey, Joe, I want to thank you for coming by, and we wish you all the best with your 1994 schedule. Sounds like you're booked up pretty solid.
I'm pretty busy, yeah.
And we'll look forward to seeing you here in Pasadena with the Guitar Summit group, as well as various other...
Whatever else I'm doing.
Yeah.
Which I don't know. Oh, yeah. Well, I don't know. No.
Go ahead.
I don't know.
Come on.
I don't remember.
Well, thanks anyway for coming by. Good luck.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm playing in Ojai, in case you're interested.
Go ahead.
I'm playing in a place called...
The Hot Springs up there?
Hot Springs Spa Resort.
Right.
Yeah. And
beautiful
on the
place.
12th, on the 12th of this month, which is Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
And I have to know how to get there, because I don't know how to get there.
Take the 134.
Yeah.
And it turns into the 101.
Yeah.
And just take it all the way through Ventura.
Yeah.
And then you are heading up towards Carpinteria, and there's an Ojai, I think it's 33.
Yeah.
Hang a right, and it'll take you right to Ojai.